Welcome, everybody, to Logan Metro Sports Center as the Brisbane Bullets return to action here in the NBL as they tip off their return to competition, taking on the UCLA Bruins of Los Angeles, California. Right off the top, I want to let you guys know we've had some technical difficulties, so we've had to go to our backup camera angle. We're all good now, though, and we will have this stream for you going. I'm John Guarn. I'm joined tonight by Dave Derwin and Dan George. Guys, this is excitement. I've never seen a crowd like this for basketball here in Brisbane. The Bullets are back. How good is this, Dave?
Yeah, well, it's a long time coming. I mean, the last game for the club was in 2008, and Bullets are back. So it's great to see that for all those basketball fans in Brisbane.
And not only was their last game in 2008, but this is a storied franchise in the NBL. It's been a real shame that we haven't been able to see the Bullets play on this court. Dan, what does it mean for the community here in Brisbane to see the Bullets back in action?
Well, it's massive for a number of reasons. Obviously, having a national team to support. We're such a proud sporting state in Queensland, specifically in Brisbane. It's just such a wonderful thing for the juniors in the community to be able to come and look at an event like this. And not only the Bullets, but UCLA are one of the most storied college programs in the history of the game. So for them to be here tonight with what is an amazingly talented recruiting class with Lonzo Ball and the team that they've brought out here, that's going to be a great event, and what a way to introduce basketball back into Brisbane.
Talking about UCLA and their storied record, I'm taking a look at their all-time scoring leaders. And guys, there's NBA talent littered throughout the history of this program. You're talking about arguably one of the greatest, if not the best, college basketball program of all time. It goes back to the days of the legendary John Wooden. You're talking about Bill Walton. We're talking about Kareem Abdul-Jabbar when he was Lou Alcindor. Let's take a look. Jason Capono, Reggie Miller, Ed O'Bannon. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. This is a real honor for us to be able to have UCLA come here to Brisbane and play against the returning Bullets. What a way to tip off the return of the Bullets.
Yeah, well, as Thunder mentioned, plenty of NBA prospects here for UCLA. They've won the most NCAA titles, 11 all-time with UConn. And now they've got a great up-and-coming class here. And it's just exciting to see the Bullets back as well, Thunder. What are some of the things for Brisbane you think we're looking for tonight?
Well, I think the first and most important thing for me watching tonight's game is some of the studs aren't playing. Adam Gibson, an Olympian, he's not playing. A couple of the imports are out. But the team that they put on the floor is a talented group. But more than anything, we want to give the people of Brisbane a show. We're back. We're going to set the right culture. We're going to set the right example for you to get behind us and support us in what's going to be a massive year for us firstly coming back into the league. So for me tonight, I expect all of these guys to come out with a massive amount of energy, make sure that they put on a show for tonight's crowd, which is packed here in Logan. And there are a couple of guys like the Lucas Walker who've been in the league for a decade and can't get a contract. That's the level of talent we've now got in the NBL. So it's going to be a mixture of guys putting on a show now that we're back in Brisbane and guys fighting for a professional contract. So it should be a great contest.
Yeah, and obviously everyone's going to, some of these young guys are starting to look for minutes, right? So you've got guys that are signed and you've got guys that are still looking for, some of that 11th and 12th spot. I think tonight, obviously, Coach Lamanis, or maybe it's going to be Coach Bruton, I think, as Dre's maybe having a couple more days holiday. We'll soon find out.
Much deserved after
at the tip off.
A pretty awesome Olympic campaign.
Absolutely, a fantastic Olympic campaign from the Boomers, and congratulations to Dre, that's for sure. And again, I think, him and CJ will be in particular be looking at, how some of these younger guys fit into the system, how they're communicating defensively, how they're picking up their schemes, and obviously offensively, you got to execute, right? So he wants guys that can understand the offense, get the shots they're looking to get. And this is, again, early preseason for the Bullets. So just a good run to play against such a historic
no doubt
college.
And I think this game is equally as important for UCLA as well. It's obviously an exhibition tour for them, and I know we've got a lot of people watching from the United States of America at tonight's stream. As we've discussed, they're one of the proudest, if not the most proudest and well-known of all college basketball programs. May not have had the success that they're used to recently, but the group that they've brought back, the returning players, are first class, all Pac-12 type of players, and the juniors that they brought in terms of incoming freshman class, are possibly one and done type NBA players. So we would expect them on tour in Australia. I know it's an exhibition season, but they want to go back in rhythm, in tune, ready to step back up to where they think they belong at the top of the conference.
Yeah, that first game for UCLA here in Australia was a 123-76 win over Sydney University. They had 7 players in double digits in that one. They had 33 assists on 49 field goals made. They were led by the freshman TJ Leaf. He's one of those talented freshmen. Bryce Alford had 17 points and 5 rebounds. You had Isaac Hamilton with 18 points and 9 rebounds. And Aaron Holiday had another huge game also in that one. He nearly had a triple-double, okay? But then they step up the level of competition in their last game out to take on a Melbourne United team who has their eyes set on an NBL championship. And the level of play went up and the level of competition went up. UCLA dropped a narrow loss, 89-84 to Melbourne United. In that game, we saw some of the younger players. They probably tailed off a little bit in between those games. So it's a great opportunity for them to get playing time against some really high-quality competition, which will steal them for this tremendous Pac-12 season coming up.
Well, absolutely, and they're playing against 25, 26, 30-year-old men. So no matter how talented you are as a 19, 20, 21-year-old, that difference in body size is going to be something which they can then take back to the college program, which I think is going to really help them this season. That's probably one of the reasons they come on a tour like this.
Yeah, and that's exactly it. They come on a tour to gel. They have such a young team coming onto the floor. They also have a lot of talent in the upper levels, though, as well. You look at Thomas Walsh. You look at Bryce Alford. Bryce Alford, when I'm looking at the record books here in UCLA, he's steadily climbing his way up the record books as well. He's number 2 on the 3-point field goals made list, just behind Jason Capono. Capono is arguably one of the greatest 3-point shooters of all time. So,
well, let's look at the shooters that they've had. And most recently, for especially the fans here watching, a guy like Kevin Love and Russell Westbrook are UCLA grads as well. So when you put guys on the all-time list above that quality of player, you know you're going to watch something pretty special tonight.
Yeah, you've got guys who have relatives in the NBA, Isaac Hamilton, Aaron Holiday. You've got Lonzo Ball, who is arguably the number one high school player now coming into a college program. Everyone's talking about him being one and done, so it's a great opportunity for some of these young guys in the Bullets as well to face that level of competition. It may be their one and only time to face a level that high.
Yeah, and I think obviously they struggled a little bit, some of the teams, with the length and size is what has sort of bothered Melbourne and the Sydney University teams earlier in this week. But again, as Dan was saying, the young guys from UCLA have got to get used to the physicality of the sort of Australian basketball, which, you know, the world obviously saw with the recent Olympics, with us playing what the Serbians say, man basketball. So, you know, you've got to love that quote.
Yeah, and we're very close to tip. Again, guys, I just wanted to let you know the shot that we have on the court is our backup shot. Unfortunately, we had some technical difficulties, but we're very happy to bring you this amazing stat. Guys, it's going to be a great game. Let's get ready for tip. The Brisbane Bullets, for their first time back on the court in Brisbane, they're going to have Anthony Petrie, Daniel Kickert, Tom Jervis, Sean Bruce, and Ruben Tarangi on the starting lineup. Then we look at UCLA. You've got Thomas Welsh, Isaac Hamilton, Lonzo Ball, Bryce Alford, and number 0, Alex Olesinski. So get set for the tip here, boys. It's going to be a great one. Jervis is going to tip off, jump with Thomas Welsh here. Tip is up, and it's won by the Bullets. Nice way to start their return to hoops here in Brisbane. A lot of talk on the court here. See it from Bryce Alford. Back door to Tarangi. He picks up the dribble, finds a cutting Jervis. Jervis' hook shot is off, and Walsh comes down with the rebound. And they go right to Lonzo Ball. Let's see what Ball can do. He's guarded first up by Tarangi. Now Alford has it inside to Welsh. Back out to Hamilton. Hamilton fires a 3 that rattles home. First points of the game go to the Bruins. It's going to be interesting to see, because the Bullets haven't really had a full squad to practice with here. Tarangi has it now. He's going to bring things back out. Go to Kickert with Ball on him. Kickert's going to go to work, spinning baseline. Jump shot is good. Veteran play there by Daniel Kickert.
Well, I think we're going to see two contrasting styles to a point tonight. I think the Bullets, they're big guys, are essentially perimeter guys. And so they're going to run these handoff action to try and get switches and mismatches like we just saw for Kickert, whereas UCLA are trying to play inside out, post those guys up and get shooters off that.
Yeah, 7 on the shot clock here. Olesinski gets it over to Ball. Now Alford, he's going to fire a deep 3. It's up. It's good. That's basically shooting from LA there. 6-2 the lead.
Well, you know, he liked your pump up before the game, Johnny. And again, he hit six against Melbourne the other night. So he certainly has the range and has a green light.
Yeah, Petrie hits one over Ball. That's a tough matchup for Alonzo Ball. Now Hamilton coming off the baseline screen. He drives baseline now. Good hesitation dribble. Goes through the defense. Misses the layup. He tips it out to Olszynski. Now Welsh. Jumper's good. So UCLA firing on all cylinders here to start. They're up 8-4.
Yeah, the Bruins obviously starting to get a bit more familiar with each other. Now, obviously having spent a bit of time together now.
Tarangi with the finger roll. Can't get it to fall, but he's fouled. He's going to go to the line for a couple shots.
Yeah, offensively they look real sharp. And I guess on the flip side, the Bullets defense needs to tighten up a little bit here.
I think that comes with familiarity as well. I mean, it's one thing we talk about offensive and trying to gel, which comes as you play more together, but equally so defensively, there are structures and systems that these guys are going to try and implement, which for a lot of these new players into Brisbane, which is everybody, since it's a new team, is going to take some time to pick up as well. So I think it's such a valuable game for the Bullets to try and implement some of their rules that they've been working on against each other to now put it up against a quality outfit like the UCLA Bruins.
Yeah, and let's talk about this crowd. How good is the crowd here in Logan tonight for the return of the Brisbane Bullets? I mean, we got to give the Bullets credit for getting this crowd here tonight. It's an absolute sellout. The place is packed.
Well, the Bullets have done an awesome job at introducing themselves back into the community. And I think the ticket sales early on and then a game like this and the crowd that's here just show how hungry Brisbaneites are for their basketball.
Yeah, it's great to see more of those college teams coming over. Obviously, they have restrictions on how often they can come.
Well, how about
that? As Petrie goes to the bucket.
D-Love, last year we got Ben Simmons running around here in Brisbane in the preseason, which is awesome. He's now the number one pick. Now, you fast forward 12 months, we've got a program like UCLA, which we've discussed with guys like Lonzo Ball and these other players who are going to be pros.
Yeah.
So for the people of Brisbane, we get to watch the Bullets back, which is awesome. And then we're going to be able to see in 2 or 3 years' time all these NBA players running around that we saw close up on a night like this.
Yeah, I think, you know, one of the things that people don't talk about when these teams come out on tour also is you have these senior guys who may not be NBA level. They're definitely pros, though. It's a good opportunity for the NBL teams to scout these teams as well to look for potential imports in the years to come.
Yeah, and again, let's be real. Not everyone is just because they go to D1 is going to make the NBA. So a lot of these guys are also looking at possibly careers here in Australia, maybe after their career.
Olszynski hits a three. Oh, they're going to call it a two. It's 11-8. UCLA is come out here firing, guys. How about Petrie? There was a great story by our mate Braden Hesselhurst in the paper today, how he signed with the Bullets in 2008. Then they folded as they get kickered for a travel after he finished. But how about that? Petrie signs with the Bullets. The Bullets then fold. Now he's back in 8 years' time, finally getting the chance to put the Bullets uniform on.
Yeah, I think he's the great kind of, you know, the guy we talked about. We talked about the QBL this recently that's just finished up here with Tanner McGrew as a great team guy that can do lots of things. Petrie's the same guy. You know, he can score, rebound, pass, smart defender. I think he's one of those glue guys that Brisbane will certainly depend upon this year.
Isaac Hamilton with another baseline jumper. Lead is 13-8 now for UCLA over the Bullets. Bruce off the dribble. He kicks it into the corner. Good save by Petrie. Hamilton can't control it. He loses it out of bounds. That's a turnover there for UCLA.
And we can see the Bullets running some familiar sets from the old New Zealand Breakers days, which is a lot of two big men coming high and they're going dribble handoffs. The first dribble handoff from the first pick dives to the basket looking for that high-low action, and so far it's working out okay. They're getting some great looks off it, especially with someone like Kickett, who's such a great shooter from the outside.
And it's a great, again, we keep saying the opportunity for UCLA. Great dish inside from Petrie to Kickett. He finishes in the foul. How about the creativity there from Petrie hitting Kickett naked on the baseline?
Yeah, we're just giving him some love, and that's exactly what he does. Kind of like similar to what Boucher did for the Bullets, the one the title. The latter years there. And that's what he does. He did it in New Zealand as well.
Well, I think what's overlooked with Petrie a lot of the time, given he's been in the league for going on a decade probably with the Gold Coast and the Razorbacks, Adelaide and now Brisbane, is that he bided his time in the Seabowl for the Canberra Gunners for years and dominated before he got a chance. So it's just so awesome to watch someone who's just persisted and now put together a really, really professional career. which has been impressive to watch from a distance.
And we see, checking in for the Brisbane Bullets, young Matt Kenyon. He's just starting out his professional career as Welsh hits the baseline jumper for UCLA. At the moment, they're just dominating the offense here.
Yeah, and I mean, Matt Kenyon, he's a great young prospect. I know Coach Lamanis and CJ Bruton are really high on him. Terrific athlete, and we're really interested to see what he can do this year.
That foul is called on Isaac Hamilton. Tarangi shooting a three. That's the fourth team foul for UCLA. Coach Steve Alford going to go to the bench, and he's going to insert Aaron Holiday. So Holiday coming in off the bench tonight for the Bruins. Four team fouls here for UCLA with about 6 minutes to go in the first quarter.
Well, it's such great learning experiences for everybody that plays the game, but especially for a young group like this. I mean, you've got a pretty good lead. UCLA's playing really well, looking pretty smooth on offense, and you just don't want to foul a three-point shooter and put him to the line. The clock stops. You give Brisbane potentially 3 points to get themselves back in the game.
Tarangi coming over from the New Zealand Breakers. He's got championship, NBL championship experience. I really like what the Bullets have put together. They've got a nice mix of young and experience on this roster. And again, you know, it's early days. This is their first exhibition. And everyone in the preseason thinks they got a title shot, but I put the Bullets in that contention for a final spot.
Well, they've got quality players, and you know they're going to be well coached. CJ Bruton, the assistant coach, is obviously a legend of our game. And you've got the national coach who was a whisker away from a medal at the Olympics. So you know they're going to be drilled and well structured. And they've got the talent to buy in, the guys who want to win.
Scrap for the rebound. Tarangi tries to throw it off Welsh. Welsh recovers. Ball now hits Alford. Alford's fouled by Bruce. He's going to go to line for two shots. Very crafty play there by Bryce Alford.
Yeah, got him up in the air and took advantage of it. And we'll go to the line now.
15-14 the lead here for UCLA. Over the Bullets. About 5:45 to go. Not shooting foul. Interesting. Going to go sideline out of bounds. Holiday has it now for the Bruins. Gets it over to Alford. Alford can't handle the pass. He loses it out of bounds right in front of his team's bench.
Yeah, good defensive energy from Bruce. Getting up and in, trying to force the action.
Here's another one of those impressive freshmen checking in for UCLA. TJ Leaf. And checking in for the Brisbane Bullets, that's Lucas Walker. TJ Leaf, he was the leading scorer in the opening game of the tour here for UCLA. He had 21 points and 9 rebounds. Also had 3 assists. He's also had huge reps on him. He could play it inside and out. Very athletic player. I'm excited to see what he can do. Well, Bruce comes off the curl. Tarangi has it now with 8 seconds to go. Trying to cross over. Spins on Alford. Flips one up and in. Ruben Tarangi has it going on.
Great move. And pretty well defended.
Really well defended, yeah. Just a quality finish. But coming back to TJ Leaf for a second, I mean, him and Lonzo Ball, and I mean, all three of their starters are top 25 ranked high school players, but they're now taking a step up, playing in a tough conference for the Bruins, and that now means nothing. It's a chance for him to prove himself, because he's got to earn his minutes again, yeah, coming in as a freshman. So here's a chance for him to show something what he's got.
He hits the nice turnaround baseline jumper over Lucas Walker. Kicker going to take Leaf into the post. Good up and under move. Banks it in, and the foul. He had the freshman Leaf guessing. He got him up in the air and then got the foul and the finish.
Well, you know, Kickett's been in the game a long time, and he's licking his chops right now as the youngster, how he's down there defending him. Equally down the other end, Leaf had a good move. And I think that, you know, he's got that real good length to him as well.
Let's see if Kicker can finish the three-point play to put the Bullets up by two. And he does, so it's 19-17 now for the Bullets over UCLA. Holiday hits ball. His first jumper is up. It's off the side of the rim. He hustles and gets his own rebound. Flips it out now for Holiday. Holiday gets to the rim. Can't finish with the left hand. Two attempts there for Anigbogu. He can't finish. And then they're going to call basket interference, I think.
Yeah, that's right. Yep. Thought of goaltending. I think one of the Bullets accidentally grabbed the net, fighting for that rebound, which obviously is an interference and the right call by the official. Hey,
block out. Hey, secondary. So Anibogu will get credited for a couple rebounds there. He tipped it around and then he got the bucket to fall as well. You get credited for the points on that one, don't you?
You sure do. Closest man gets the points, which is a good feeling when you're a big guy. You need every point you can get, so you take two like that.
Petrie with the offensive rebound, and putback is good by Petrie. Ball putting on the Jets. He put the skates on there. Leaf fires a three. That's off the front of the rim. No good. Onabogu comes up with the offensive rebound. He's tipped around a few. He's probably got five offensive boards. His Alford's three is short, and Kenyon comes down with it. Now Bruce's pass stolen by Ball. It's a bit short there. Now Alford off and running for the Bruins. Gets it over to Ball. Very interesting here. They got Ball playing the point. Alford off him. Screen and roll for Onabogu, and then they're going to get Petrie for the reach around.
Yeah, and you can just tell, obviously, the ball just oozes class. I mean, you know, he just moves around a bit like Ben Simmons last year, I think, too, Dan. Just, yeah, you know, gracefully around the court, and I think he's in about second gear at best, maybe.
I agree. And I've watched a lot of tape on him the last week or so in preparation for tonight. And, I mean, he's a great passer. That's one thing that we'll notice. And he's athletic as hell. I mean, he can get up and finish with the best of them.
Yep.
And his shot's uncanny. Like, it's not a smooth-looking J, but it's really effective. So he's really got all the tools and the kind of length to be a great defensive player as well. So as this game heats up, I think at the moment he's getting a feel for it, making sure everybody gets a touch. But as this game progresses, I'd love to see him take over and be a bit more aggressive.
Alford using the body to create some space. Gets it to fall. Great bucket there from Bryce Alford. We're not at 21 with 3:15 to go. We see Ryan Vines, the captain of the Southwest Metro Pirates, getting some run here with the Brisbane Bullets. Walker hands off for Kenyon. Now Jervis has it. Looks back door instead. Hands off for Petrie. Petrie trying to get Ball off his feet. He does, and finishes with the jumper. Petrie looking pretty good here early.
Yeah, and again, on this particular group, he's looking to get it done offensively and be a leader, which is exactly what the Bullets are after.
Leaf baseline jumper is short. Jervis, no, it's Onabogu who tips it out of bounds. He's a big boy, Onabogu.
One of the things that we've said about the Bullets and the way they've constructed their rosters, they've got a lot of bigs with Jervis and obviously a couple of guys not playing tonight, and Mitch Young. So it's interesting to see Petrie, who's probably a four, even a small ball five, is playing the three spot. And so far, he's really effective.
Well, again, I mean, he's had Ball on him a little bit tonight as well, and he'd probably like that matchup and trying to get him in the block. Absolutely. Vines come out shooting.
Yeah, Vines lets it go, and he hits his first shot of the night. It's 25-21 the lead now here for the Bullets.
Good spacing early here from the Bullets, again, letting the offense to do its thing and guys giving them the creativity.
Ball very short on that three-point attempt. He gets in the passing lane, though, comes up with a steal. Kicks ahead for Leaf. Leaf goes right to the bucket. Left-handed shot, no good. Ball with the nice tip over Lucas Walker. Lucas Walker is one of our most athletic players, and Ball just jumped over him.
Well, you can just see the absolute athleticism from Ball. And it doesn't look like he's broken a sweat yet.
Kenyon with a nice reverse layup. Coach C.J. Bruton takes a timeout with about 1:47 to go.
That was a great finish from a young player, catching it in traffic in the crafty reverse.
Yeah, Walker hits Kenyon back door. Kenyon finishes with the reverse layup. That's a timeout on the floor, guys, so we'll take one as well. A minute 50 to go here in the first quarter. It's a 27-23 lead for the Brisbane Bullets over the UCLA Bruins. To the Logan Sports Complex here in Brisbane, Australia. It's the Brisbane Bullets returning to the court for the first time since 2008. They're hosting the UCLA Bruins, and at the moment, the Bullets are up by four, 27-23. Coming out of a timeout for the Bullets there, what do you think Coach Bruton's telling the troops?
Well, I think they just missed a couple of assignments defensively, and also a bit of rebounding is certainly what he needs to work on. The last couple of minutes, they probably got four or five offensive rebounds. And again, they're young guys from UCLA, so the Bullets got to use their veteran experience, be physical, send a message that, you know, they're here to play. Young fellas, get out of the way.
Yeah, Gigi Goleman just checked into the game for UCLA. He had Walker on his back. He went to the basket, was fouled. So Goleman's going to go to the free throw line for two shots. These are his fifth and sixth free throws of the tour. He is now far down under.
Yeah, probably another maybe going through is their offensive transition. Again, ball's at the back there, and he's read a couple of, you know, a couple of pretty simple passes and picked them off. So again, in their transition, just got to...
Moment goes off the Jervis screen, picks up his dribble, hits Kenyon on the vines. He'll fire a three. Onabogu comes up with another rebound. Now Hamilton has it, and he carries the ball. So turnover there for Isaac Hamilton. Just got a little bit too excited. Good defense there, though, by young Matt Kenyon.
Yeah, Kenyon's been really impressive, I think, two of the last. First time in a Bullets jersey. Defensively, he's been really good.
Vines calling out the play. He's battling with Aaron Holiday. Walker hits Kenyon against Leaf. He's double teamed. Good pass inside. The reverse layup is no good. Tipped around. Coming down with it is Holiday. Someone's lost the shoe here. It's on Onabogu. Now Leaf finds Hamilton in the corner. Three-pointer is short. Petrie comes up with the rebound. Bullets really looking to attack the glass as Walker goes reverse and finishes with the left hand. Good finish there from Lucas Walker.
Yeah, great seal from Jarvis, two under the bucket, which allowed Walker to drive baseline.
I think Brisbane's doing a great job balancing early offense. It looks like that in transition. And when they don't get that, they're doing a great job of really focusing on getting it into the post. And they're obviously trying to beat up these younger Bruins down low in the block.
Holiday is fouled there by Jervis. That's the 15th foul, so that's going to send Jervis to the line for, Holiday to the line for a couple of shots with 6 seconds to go in the quarter.
Guys, I'm really impressed with the way UCLA is playing. It's not easy to fly half around the world when you're 18, 19, 20 years of age, travel around a new country, all the touristy stuff, and still stay focused on the task at hand. So credit their staff for keeping them ready. But they've come out in front of a pretty good crowd. I know that's nothing new for these guys, considering the crowds in America, but they're playing really composed basketball for the most part.
And yeah, they had a great day at the beach on the Gold Coast. So nice and relaxing. They were able to chill. I think they went for a bit of a swim, even though it was a bit cool. But these guys are used to the cool weather over in Los Angeles. I'm sure they'd hit the beach up. 5 seconds now on the shot clock. Vines has it. Looking to get in the paint. Throws up the teardrop over the tall defense. It's no good. The tip wouldn't have counted anyway. And that's the end of the first quarter. It's a 29-26 lead for the returning Brisbane Bullets over the UCLA Bruins. Guys, we'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll see if we can get some stats for you. And don't forget, guys, at halftime, we have a very exciting announcement. It's another partnership for the Brisbane Bullets. We will reveal that at halftime. It's now 29-26 Bullets over UCLA here from Logan Sports Complex.
I think it's awesome. I mean, it's a... provides a foundation for the NBL to really grow in this country. Big basketball fans and want to see the sport as big as it possibly can be. So this TV deal, we're looking forward to.
Come on.
Feel it coming in the air. I'm addicted to the thrill. It's a dangerous life.
Logan Sports Complex here in Brisbane, Australia. It's 29-26, the lead for the Bullets over UCLA. Dave,
let's see, for the Bullets fans, shooting 66% so far, but that's okay. They've been good looks offensively, and they're getting a bit of penetration. For the UCLA Bruins, you know, they've got plenty of shots, and a lot of them have come off offensive rebounds, 10 of 24 at 41%. As Leafs going to work.
Offense by Bruce getting in the way of Holiday.
Yeah, and sorry, John, just get back the points. Obviously, they're sharing the share 5 points. Bryce Alford's got 5 as well. Welsh with 4, and most almost...
Kickard has it, gets the screen from Tarangi. He's going to take Hamilton out. Now Tarangi has it again, working against Goleman. Flips one up. It's no good. Jervis, offensive rebound. He loses it, though, to Holiday. Now Holiday on the way up the court. He's fouled there by Tarangi. Holiday didn't like the foul. Tarangi just trying to get a shoulder in front. Got him with the body and took him down.
And the Bruins have done a great job hitting the glass too. I mean, one of the reasons they do have so many shots is 9 offensive rebounds, which to them, give them credit. But we've spoken before about the Bullets being older, bigger bodies. So Coach Lamanis, Coach Bruden, you can't accept that if you're the Bullets. And I'm sure that will be a focus of them in this half, or this quarter rather, is keeping the Bruins out of the paint and off the glass.
Yeah. That's a nice move there by Leaf. Not bad for 6'10". Hey, putting the ball on the deck and
painting again. Great rip to the middle and super finish over the top of Peach.
Great pump fake by kicker. Can't finish. It's tipped up by Tarangi and it rattles in. 31-28 the lead now for the Bullets. Tarangi goes to his left, pulls up for the jumper. It's short. Bit overexcited on the jump shot. He looked a bit frustrated on that one. It was a good look for him, though.
Well, you know, Dan, on offense, they've been really good so far, patient. And that was maybe just a bit of a quick one.
Well, I think that's always a challenge, especially as a younger player, is knowing when to come down and take that early shot and when you need to come down and get through structures, run your sets, especially if these guys are going back with a longer shot clock. We're playing with 24 tonight. These guys are probably used to playing with a longer clock than that in the American system. But it's also hard when you're as talented as Leaf is.
Good pass there from Hamilton to Welsh. He finishes the alley-oop with the layup.
Well, they had 120-odd on against Sydney Uni. You wouldn't see that in too many D1 collegiate
games. I
agree.
But let's not forget, Leaf's an all-American high school player who's probably had the green light on every possession for his team. He's now coming to a really talented UCLA group, and he's got to learn to balance when to attack and when to pull it out and run something structured.
Jervis lost the ball on the ground there. He got tied up. I say possession arrow favors the Brisbane Bullets. And Bryce Alford in for Holiday, and Leaf going to get a breather. He had the two guards with call a foul inside by for Ball's first personal foul. It's the second, the quarter. Checking in for the first time tonight is Jared Bairstow. Bruce coming in off the screen here. Working against Alford. He steps back, hits Petrie on the block against Ball. Petrie likes the matchup. He's going to fade away jump. It's no good. Tarangi with the one-handed rebound. Can't finish the follow, though. Welsh comes down with it for UCLA. Oh,
great job of Tarangi hitting the glass, but didn't come up with a bucket. He's going to get a quick foul there. Trying to stay in front of Ball, which is going to be a tough ask for anyone tonight.
Yeah, not too much you can do about that one, no. Is there?
When there's a bunch of videos floating around on Alonzo Ball and Westbrook, that might be partly because he's in the UCLA program. I'm not sure that there is another Russell Westbrook in the world.
Yeah.
But it just shows that how explosive he is to even draw that comparison. And hopefully we see more and more of that tonight like we did on that possession.
He misses them both. Both of the free throws can't fall.
It'd be interesting, too, to see how he develops, whether he's, you know, a one or a two in the NBA. And that's been some of the talk as well, Johnny.
Kicker hands off for Bairstow. Bairstow going against Ball. Baseline jumper is good for Jared Bairstow. And again, Bullets doing a good job recognizing that mismatch. Ball's been caught up on bigs every time down the offensive end.
Well, the Bullets are coming down, going dribble hands off with the big. And if that guy switches, the big's going straight to the block. So something UCLA has got to adjust on is these bigs aren't coming dribble handoff for the guard to shoot it. Stay with your man, trying to get switched, because at the moment you're getting beat up down low.
Yeah, Gallman going to get called for the foul. Bullets looking to work the ball inside out. That's a trademark of an Andre Lamanis team, isn't it?
It sure is, and I think that shows in the recruiting that they've done. I mean, Jared Bairstow, very hard worker, really talented player, and I hope he has a lot of success in the NBL. But let's not forget that he is the poorer of the Bairstow brothers, at least at this stage. You've got Cameron Bairstow to come back in, Jervis, Petrie, Mitch Young. There's a lot of good big guys, so you know that they're going to have a focus of playing down low in the paint with the roster they put together.
Yeah, Petrie is blocked there by Gallman. They're going to say that Gallman got him with the arm. So Petrie is going to go to the line for a couple of free throw opportunities.
Yeah, I was going to say, you know, in addition to the Australian content, I think they've done a good job with their imports as well. You know, tried and tested in Torrey Craig and Bill. And I think that they will both add a little bit of that 3-point firepower when they come in.
Well, we spoke earlier about putting a product on the floor for the Bullets community, and all of us here in Southeast Queensland is going to win and challenge for a title straight up. So they've gone out and got a mixture of younger players like a Kenyon, but there's Daniel Kickets, there's Petries, Adam Gibson, who's won titles. And you go to the imports, and you've got Beal, who's coming off titles and grand final series, and obviously Torrey Craig, who may not have won one, but he's been to the grand final. So we've got proven winners on the team, and that's the kind of culture that's going to be adored and loved by the community from day one.
Alford makes it rain from the corner, cuts the lead to one, 34-33. Gee, you can't give him a millimeter, he'll fire right over you. Petrie going to the rack. He's fouled, hits the wall quite hard. Let's hope he's all right. That one, that foul is going to go on Alex Olashinsky. That's Olashinsky's second personal foul and UCLA's 15th foul, so they're in the penalty.
And again, good kick ahead early from Ball, and that's something that we talked about a little bit earlier, is about his vision, which one of his trademarks, pushing the ball, kicking ahead to the base, and Alford's green light, lights out shooter. And that's what UCLA Bruins are going to look forward to more of this year.
Yeah, I think
next year, sorry.
Yeah, you know, UCLA has, they play in arguably the toughest conference in all of NCAA Division I basketball in the Pac-12. You've got powerhouses in Arizona, Washington, UCLA. You got USC, Washington State, Arizona State is strong. The Bruins are going to be in for battles like this night in and night out in the conference. And this is just great preparation for them heading into the season. I always find it interesting that they come and they travel during the summertime, which is a great bonding opportunity, but the season doesn't start until November. But one of the strengths of getting these tours is you're able to actually practice as a team during the summer, and then you have all these games as well. So Ball going one-on-one, a lot of contact there, no foul called. He's slow to get up. Good recovery there by Hamilton. He slips, loses the ball. Kenyon finishes the turnover. Looks a bit slippery on the court. I've seen a few of the guys slip around there. Alford working on Bruce, hits Welsh. Welsh keeping it high, hands off now for Ball. Alford gets free, he's gonna fire a deep two, that's off. The ball is gonna go out of bounds. It's gonna be Brisbane basketball. And the Bullets legend himself, Sam McKinnon, gonna check in for Anthony Petrie. Dave, you know Sam McKinnon pretty well. This guy was a high flyer in his day. If you thought of the Bullets, he's one of the first guys you think of.
Oh, absolutely, and a, you know, an Olympian, an outstanding player for the in the NBL for a long time, and great to see the Bullets give him a little bit of love with a throwback game.
Yeah, we got to give Bairstow a bit of love there, putting the ball on the deck and getting to the rim. He's got the tough assignment on Ball. Ball splits the D, hits Hamilton. Hamilton now over to Welsh, who can't handle the pass. It's out of bounds. So another turnover there from UCLA. And TJ Leaf going to check back in for Alex Olashinsky.
Really interesting right now with Bairstow having to guard Ball. And again, this is with Jared's future. As in, you know, what is he? Is he a two? Is he a three at this level? So far, he's doing a good job of staying in front of Ball.
Yeah, I think he's going to be, if he's in the NBL, as kicker hands off inside. Sam McKinnon misses the layup. Somehow Bruce comes up with it. Now to kicker, he'll fire the top of the key. Three, it's good. It's 43-33. Bullets starting to run away here for a bit. Don't forget, guys, at halftime, we're going to have the reveal of the new partnership for the Brisbane Bullets. C.J. Bruton going to get the timeout call here at the next dead ball opportunity. Hamilton puts it on the deck. He's got 5 seconds on the shot clock. Welsh has it on the baseline. Now Ball, he'll fire the wing three. That's short. Tipped around, McKinnon tips it over to Bruce.
Yeah, and again, defensively, Brisbane's looking good the last couple minutes. You know, great show from Kickett on that last on ball.
Tated initially, I thought he should have just taken it up and fired away, but he got the foul call, so he'll go to the line for a couple shots.
And basketball is such a global game now. I mean, everybody who watches basketball at any level knows that. And so the style of game, maybe to what we play here in Australia, might be slightly different to what these guys play, but I think what they're doing defensively, Brisbane, is they're switching the on-ball. So Kickett wasn't really showing. He just switched it.
Yeah.
So I would love for the UCLA Bruins to say, well, if they're going to put their big guy, meaning Brisbane's big fellas, on a Lonzo Ball on a switch, I know we run our offenses, but why don't we pull the ball out? If you see that, Lonzo, pull it out. Give yourself an ISO. Everyone space the ball and see if he can't get some penetration. I think at the moment they're caught a little bit between trying to run their stuff and be really structured like a traditional college team. But I love when they see mismatches like that present to recognize that and give someone like Lonzo Ball the ability to go ISO and create for himself.
I think Ball has tried to get a couple ISOs going for himself. He struggled a little bit to find his shot at the moment. He's only got the 1 point on the free throw make. So at the moment, he's got 2 points on the layup. But UCLA is doing, this is why they're here on the
Absolutely.
Tour, working out the kinks, getting used to the offense, seeing what opportunities their offense presents to them defensively as well.
No doubt.
And I think they're doing a decent job defensively because Coach Alford is doing an interesting thing here. Like I said earlier, he's gone with a big lineup, a traditional lineup of three bigs and two guards. But quite often, and this is the lineup we've seen most, is the three-guard lineup. We've seen Hamilton, Holiday, Alford, and Ball kind of rotating between those three out of those four, and then the big rotation of Welsh, Leaf, Olszynski a bit, and Golliman. So when they have to recognize defensively when they have those three guards who's going to switch and when they should switch.
I agree, and they have been good defensively. And I mean, UCLA's big guys are skilled big guys. A lot of, with all respect, American post players are just really strong, really good post players, but on the perimeter is not as great in terms of shooting touch, whereas these guys tonight are showing range. But in saying that, they're defending Kickets, Petries, Bestos, Jervis even, who are very much perimeter big. So defensively, they're doing well, especially since they're having to guard almost out of position.
And here's Bairstow matched up with Leaf now. Good hedge and recovery there by Bairstow. Ball has it now over to Holiday with 9 seconds on the shot clock. He fires a three. It's good.
Pretty silky smooth, Jimmy, from there.
Yeah, Aaron Holiday hits the three-pointer. It cuts the lead now to 8, 44-36 for the Bullets over UCLA. Kicker now with Leaf on him. Goes inside for McKinnon. McKinnon going against Welsh. Welsh got a piece of that one, I think. Leaf comes down with it. Good kick ahead here for Ball. He's going to fire the three. That's short. Now Matty Kenyon kicks ahead now for Bairstow on the wing with Ball on him. Now Bruce gets the ball and calls out the play. Bruce kicks it inside for McKinnon. McKinnon finishes and the foul. How about Sammy McKinnon taking it back to the old school there, getting into the bucket and finishing through the contact.
Yeah, a lot of it happened because kick it came and again just slipped it, popping out to the three-point line. Oh, sorry, and again gave Bruce the opportunity to turn the corner.
Yeah, Bairstow is going to check out and Bruce also going to check out for Walker and Tarangi. I loved Bairstow's minutes there. I thought he was great. He got a great opportunity to defend a big and a guard.
He did a really good job.
Well, he was really good offensively and defensively.
And a bit of miscommunication in the backcourt there from UCLA. Welsh and Ball.
Maybe he just wanted to show Thunder that maybe he's the number one Bairstow in the family.
Well, I think Cam's in street clothes, so tonight he is.
Yep. If you can't have a Cam Bairstow, what could be better than having a Jared Bairstow?
Absolutely. Local boys, great family, good to see.
McKinnon against Ball. He's going baseline, leaves his feet. Pass goes out of bounds. McKinnon's got a smile on his face. Coach Bruton having a good time with his boy Sam McKinnon out on the court as well.
Well, I think 10 years ago, Sam McKinnon's ripping that and dunking on somebody. So it's just father time is undefeated, as they say.
Tarangi is going to match up here with Holiday. Holiday goes right past him. Good
great
look
pass.
Inside. Great finish and the foul by Onabogu.
Yeah, Holiday with great penetration.
Yeah, great. He got past Tarangi really quick with that first step. Got into the paint. A nice no-look pass to Onabogu, who finished. Now he'll go to the line for a three-point play opportunity. He's 7 of 8 from the free throw line on the tour down under.
I think the coaching staff will be a little bit disappointed with Tarangi too. You've got to contain your guy. And again, there wasn't really much on. They were kind of full court man, but you know, just a little bit of pressure. And again, you just got to stay in front.
I think you're right, D-Love.
Kenyon gets into the paint. He's fouled on his way up. He's going to go to the line for a couple of shots.
I think CJ might be talking to him right now about that. And it makes it pretty hard for the big to help on time if you get beat that easy. I know one of Andre's rules with the breakers was if you get beat baseline, there's going to be help. If you get beat middle, you're on your own. You're out to dry. So it obviously shows that if you're going to get beat baseline like that in transition, you'd better be able to recover.
Kenyon at the line for a couple free throws. Dave, you know Matt Kenyon a fair bit. Tell us about where he's from and how he wound up with the Bullets.
Yeah, well, he's a New South Wales born boy, which is south of the border. We don't generally like those kind of guys, but now he's wearing the right colors. And You know, I watched him in the National Under-20s where he had a great tournament. Probably threw down one of the best dunks I've seen in some time, a baseline lob. So he's a super athlete, and I think what we've seen tonight, defensively, it's been really impressive. And again, the offense will sort of come as he finds his role in the pecking order here with the Bullets.
Yeah, he's a big point guard.
Yeah,
plays the one and the two.
Yeah, probably more of a two.
Well, what better way to learn than playing behind an Adam Gibson and learning off of CJ Bruden. So his development over the next 6, 12, 18 months in this system should be great to watch.
Yeah.
And Lucas Walker just picked up the offensive foul there, battling for a position inside with Lonzo Ball. Holiday takes the pass from Leaf. Tarangi going to back off. He's got to give himself a bit of space with Holiday's quick first step. Ball comes off the down screen, skips it over to Alford. Alford's three is up. It's short. Tarangi loses it out of bounds off of his leg. So good hustle there from Holiday. He didn't give up on the play. Knocked it out of bounds off of Ruben Tarangi.
Yeah, and Alford, he doesn't need much room, does he? I mean, that was up real quick.
Now Leaf gets it. He'll hand back to Holiday. Holiday going against Tarangi. Now Alford has it top of the key. Puts it on the deck. He's got to fire along too. It's off. Jeffers comes up with the rebound. Now Kenyon has it. One on three. Goes at the defense. Flips it up. It's no good, but he's fouled. It's a great take there by the youngster, Matty Kenyon. That foul is going to go on Aaron Holiday. That's going to be Holiday's second personal. And Kenyon's at the line for two shots.
And I think he's doing his best to get some serious minutes this year.
Well, if he come in at 18 playing behind some of the guys he's playing behind, he's not going to get given anything.
Yeah.
But if he plays like this, Andre's going to have no choice but to give him minutes.
Yeah, Kenyon doing a good job here early. Misses the second one. Walker tries to save it. Leaf recovers it. Look at the big fella run the break. Euro step, lose the ball on his way up. He's fouled. They're going to give that foul to Sam McKinnon.
We said versatile before, Johnny, and Leaf just showed you going coast to coast and giving Sam McKinnon the Euro.
Yeah, McKinnon's going to check out. Isaiah Harrison going to check in for the Brisbane Bullets. We saw Harrison in the QBL. He's a fairly athletic big fella.
He had a great game. Double-double most nights, that's for sure. And did a great job with the University of Sunshine Coast. RIP, great first season for that franchise as well in the Queensland Basketball League.
Yep, Leaf hits the first one. The lead is 49-40 now for the Bullets. Hits them both. 7 points the lead here for Brisbane over UCLA. Tarangi going up against Holiday on both ends of the court here. Walker has it now inside for Jervis. Good pass, but it's stolen by Holiday. Well read by Aaron Holiday. Now Holiday going right at the defense. He's fouled. They could give that one to Jervis or Harrison. Let's see who they give it to. Yeah, that's going to go on Isaiah Harrison. Nice aggressive take there, though, by Aaron Holiday. You like that out of a point guard. Team kind of struggling a little bit offensively. Let's attack in transition.
Yeah, I mean, first quarter, they looked really slick. And the second quarter, they've sort of slowed up a little bit. Only, you know, going for a couple passes, not so much swing action. A couple ball reversals. They've just sort of tightened it a little bit. But again, like Dan was saying before, it's a bit of an adjustment because, you know, they'll probably get caught playing a little bit of Australian basketball, which is a little bit more physicality, looking to run a bit more, not so much utilizing the ball offensively. You know, again, just seeing what the defense gives you versus that discipline that a lot of the college guys have.
Holiday
running long shot clocks.
Great hands there. Picks Tarangi's pocket. Throws up a wild one. Gets it to fall. Aaron Holiday doing his best to bring the Bruins back into it. They're down four now. And again, he gets his hands on the ball from Tarangi. Tarangi turns it over. The pass up ahead, though, is recovered by Alford. Back out to Holiday. I thought that one was going up. He's got a great opportunity to ISO here with Jervis. Instead, he goes to Alford. Alford drives baseline, keeps his dribble alive. Now brings it out to Holiday. Holiday swings it. It's stolen there by Matty Kenyon. Kenyon going out to the rack. He's swatted by Holiday. Great recovery there by Aaron Holiday. Let's see if we can get a look at that one on the replay. Bit of John going back and forth. Here goes Kenyon with the steal. He jets up the court, goes right at the defense, and Holiday guts it coming down.
Well, he's showing at both ends, Holiday.
Well, I think what we've just learned in the last minute is that Aaron Holiday is legit on both ends of the floor, offensively and defensively. That last finish was as impressive a finish as you'll see.
Yeah.
I think the other thing we've learned is that Tarangi is not the backup point guard answer for Brisbane, which is fine. That's not why he was brought here, but that just shows for him stuff he needs to work on. That's what nights like this are all about.
Timeout taken on the floor. We'll take one as well. Just under a minute to go here in the first half. It's a 49-45 lead for the Brisbane Bullets over the UCLA Bruins here from Logan Sports Complex. Welcome back to the Logan Metro Sports Complex here in Southeast Queensland as the Brisbane Bullets lead the UCLA Bruins 49-45. Coach Bruton taking a timeout here. We got under a minute to go, just about 58 seconds to go in the half. Tarangi inside for Bruce, floats one up, it's missed. Tipped around, Holiday comes up with it. Up ahead for Bryce Alford. Alford loses it though on the way up.
I think you heard the footsteps behind him on that play.
Well, I was hoping he was going glass for ball.
I mean, I was getting ready for it. I don't know if Alford was ready for it, though, Dave. He lost it on the way up, unfortunately. We'll get some excitement. I can feel it. We're getting closer and closer to some big yokes. I could feel them.
I think they've unsuccessfully tried plenty so far on the tour, apparently. So hopefully they execute a few of them tonight.
Bruce working off the Jervis screen, kicks it out to Tarangi. Three-pointer is up. It's off. Jervis with the rebound. They're going to call Jervis, though, for the foul as he ripped Ike Anibogu out of the way. Very physical. Another talented freshman here for Coach Steve Alford. Ike Anibogu going to the free throw line. No, he's not. Yeah, he is.
Well,
I thought
he should,
so.
Yeah, he should be. We're in team fouls here.
I think the refs were just having a chat about it, so they got it right.
All right. I thought I was wrong, but... And Anibogu going to the free throw line for a couple. He's hit two tonight. Hits that one as well. This guy is another one of the members of this talented freshman class. Another top 25, top 50 recruit coming in for head coach Steve Alford.
Well, I was going to say a second ago that he has got a massive future. Just look at his body as a freshman. Give him a year or two in the college system. He's already shown nice touch on the jump shot. Great rebounder. When they get him in the weight room consistently, he is going to be a beast down low.
Yeah, and he's been going against, you know, solid professionals like Jarvis and Kickett.
Good pass inside. Harrison finishes off a nice play there from Ruben Tarangi. 5 seconds to go on the shot clock. Ball hits Alford. Three-pointer is up. It's good for Bryce Alford. He beats the buzzer, cutting the lead to two, heading into the half. How about that transition in 5 seconds, getting it up the court. They collapse on ball, leave Alford open. The one guy you don't want to leave open, and he makes him pay.
Well, that's the thing, John. I mean, credit ball, you're right. Did a great job of bringing up, drawing attention, and finding the open man. But Alford hitting that three is not a surprise to anybody. We've seen him light up all first half. So if you're going to leave somebody open, that's not the guy. And I'm sure they'll address that at halftime. Those sort of breakdowns is something that Brisbane's going to clean up. But let's put it this way. It's their first game as well. So I'd be surprised if they're making those errors in a month's time.
Yeah, I mean, I'd love to see the replay on that, but I think he got it through about a millimeter of a gap with Sean Bruce's hand. So, again, just showing the class.
Great first half, guys. We're going to take a break. We're going to head into halftime. But, guys, we have an exciting announcement. This is the first time you're going to see it here. It's the new and latest partnership between the Brisbane Bullets and the business community.
I think it's awesome. I mean, it provides a foundation for the NBL to really grow in this country. I think that, you know, everybody here is big basketball fans and want to see the sport as big as it possibly can be. So this TV deal with Fox Sports is awesome for the game. I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to being able to watch.
I'm ready. Come on.
Feel it coming in the air.
Yeah.
And the screams from everywhere.
Yeah.
I'm addicted to the thrill.
Play.
It's a dangerous love affair.
Sean Bruins.
Too much faith.
And the Aaron Walton. Ball on trail.
Welcome back to Logan Metro Sports Center here in Southeast Queensland. It's the Brisbane Bullets leading the UCLA Bruins 51-49 at the half. Taking a look at the halftime statistics for the Bullets, they're shooting 53% from the field, only one of three from three-point line, and 80% from the charity stripe. Leading the way in the points department for the Bullets, Daniel Kickert's got 11, and Anthony Petrie also has 11. Matt Kenyon has 7, and Ruben Tarangi has 9 as well. He's 5 of 5 from the free throw line. He's also got a couple boards and an assist. You look at UCLA stats in the first half, they shot 44.7% from the field, 37.5% from three-point land, and just over 69% from the free throw line, doing a pretty good job on the glass. UCLA, they've got 10 offensive rebounds, 21 in total. Leading the way for UCLA is Bryce Alford. He's got 11 points. Second leading scorer for the Bruins is Aaron Holiday with 8 points. He's also got 2 rebounds and 2 assists. 10 turnovers in the half for UCLA, only 9 for the Bullets in that one. So pretty good, pretty solid first half. Pretty solid first half for both teams. Guys, what did you think of that first half of action from both teams?
Well, I'm pretty excited for both squads. I think Brisbane has shown that they're going to be a force in the league as they continue to come together. And I think from UCLA's point of view, I think they've shown that they've got all the pieces to be a really quality team this season for their fans to get behind, to take them back up to the top of the Pac-12. And obviously Alford's making a move here late in the shot clock, but Coach Alford will work with them and continue to bring them together like he's done in the programs in the past.
There's the hammer and the foul by EK Anibogu. We thought he would get one to hammer down. He got it. He's dominated on the glass. That's his 5th offensive rebound of the game.
Well, I think I said before the halftime break that give him a year or two in the college system, he'll be a beast. Well, I take it back. He's a beast right now.
I was talking with Coach Bruton at the halftime, and again, he offensively likes what they're doing. Defensively, he's not happy, and they need to tighten it up, do a better job of containing their man, and also improve some of their help and split D.
3-point play by Anibogu gives the Bruins the lead again, 52-51. Jervis flips one up. It rattles around. It falls.
Nice offensive execution from the Bullets.
Yeah, good answer, too, after the 3-point play by Anibogu. 3-pointer by Ball is short. Tarangi lets it roll out of bounds.
Ball's a superstar. You can just tell he's oozing class. But that's not a good shot coming down in transition without a pass, but that's all part of being a super talented freshman.
Yeah, yeah. He's trying to get himself going. He struggled here in the first half. Obviously, UCLA sees him as an important piece of the puzzle. Jervis flips up another one. That's good.
But I think the way you get yourself going is to recognize mismatches. Run an on-ball, let them switch, and get yourself to the foul line. Get a couple of easy looks. Watch the ball go in the bucket. Then you can come down and pull up on a 3-ball like that.
Well, the Bullets like that set so much, they ran it again and got the same outcome. The Bruins have got to do a better job of defending that and also learning on the fly.
Yeah, Ball missed that one again. Chasing it down was Petrie.
We'll see if they want to milk that play again.
Well, I think you have to, and you either make UCLA adjust, which will open other plays up, or you just keep feeding the beast down low. You got to make UCLA make a change here, because so far they haven't figured out an answer for it.
Bruce comes off the screen, picks up his dribble. They work it inside down to Jervis. Jervis kicks it out for Petrie. Petrie's going to step into a long two that rolls home. Ball knocked it out of the cylinder there, so that's good for the Bullets. 57-52 the lead now.
And the Bruins did a better job of defending that one. Obviously looking to get Jarvis the ball again, and they took that away. Insane, that a good look from Peach, top of the key.
Leaf has it, looking to hand off for Alford. It's not there. They go inside to Anibogu. He gets it out to Ball. Ball crosses over, flips it up for Anibogu, who nearly finishes. It does.
That is an incredible finish.
That's just a great catch and finish there by Anibogu. Ball got himself in a little bit of trouble. He went to throw the alley-oop. Anibogu caught it and shot it all in one motion.
Well, he made the pass look a whole lot better.
Jervis gets it again on the block, looking to go against Anibogu. Likes this matchup. Again goes to the left hand. It's good. Coach Bruton likes that matchup.
Well, you got to keep going to it. And if they're not going to double, you keep going to work if you're Jervis. But Anibogu will learn that you can't play behind and let a man catch it on the block and then play D. You got to get up early and deny him position. You got to bump him right now. Because if you let big fellas, 7-footers, walk to the block, you're going to get scored on or in foul trouble or both, like we just saw in that possession.
Yeah, yeah. And that time then, you got caught in D-trans. Got to have vision for the ball and then find your cover.
Yeah, Coach Alford letting the young fella do some battling against Tommy Jervis inside. but that foul was on Abogu, so he's got two, and Coach Alford inserts Welsh in the place of Ike Anabogu. At the free throw line, Tom Jervis, he's there for two shots, hits the first one. I like the addition of Jervis, too, coming out here from Perth.
Yeah, I think it's a great signing. Again, you've kind of got the pick and pop five-man, if that's what they want to go with kick it, or equally the more traditional low-post threat, banger,
Coach Bruton's going to go to the bench here, take Jervis out after a solid few minutes of play.
Again, I think he's just going to obviously share the minutes tonight.
Holiday loves the matchup against Ruben Tarangi. Tarangi picks up another foul. Good foul call there. Holiday using that crossover dribble and that quick first step. Holiday again with Tarangi. Crosses him over, picks up his dribble, gets it out to Lonzo Ball. Ball with Kickard on him. He's going to fire a three over the defense. It's short. Welsh with another offensive rebound. Tarangi gets his hands on it. Can he chase it down? It's tipped out of bounds. They're going to say it went off the Bruins. So great hustle there by Ruben Tarangi. Ball looks really frustrated. He seems to me settling for that jump shot. It hasn't been falling yet tonight. I'd like to see him put it on the deck and attack the glass, especially when you have a matchup on a Kickard or Petrie.
I think you're right, John. And there's two ways of looking at that. One is, when you're a young kid and you're a shooter, the fact that he's still shooting, and not shooting at will, but he's letting it fly, well, you got to keep doing that. A lot of young players will back away and not want to shoot if you see a couple miss. So give him credit for continuing to let it fly, but you also have to recognize that if the jumper's not going, as we see UCLA finding Alford in transition again.
Good fight for the rebound. Comes down to Petrie.
Yeah, great. Great job.
David, talking over each other, but if the jumper's not going, you got to find other ways to get yourself going, and I think penetration, getting your feet in the paint for easier looks or foul shots is the way that he needs to adjust.
Yeah, and I really like how Leaf in particular can lead out their transition. I mean, at the 6'9 guy with handles, you know, penetrate, pitch it to Alford on the wing. I think that's going to be a pretty staple for UCLA this year.
I'd love to see them out in transition. I think the Bullets have done a good job in D-trans. Kickard has it on the block. He's going against Welsh, he shoots the air ball. Here comes Leaf again, leading the fast break. Throws the oop for Ball, who puts it down with two hands. There's the hammer we were looking for. It's the big man to the guard. Usually it's the other way around.
Well, that's the point forward, Leaf, doing his thing in trans. Again, Bullets got to stop Ball.
Absolutely, they're letting the penetration come all the way down the floor. But if Leaf's going to go pro, he's probably a three at the next level. So you need skills like that, and he's showing that.
Great pass.
Great pass from Petrie, I'm sorry, to Bruce. Bruce finishes through the foul.
How about that finish from Lonzo Ball, though, to catch it and just spike it? Just super talented player.
Let's take a look at that dunk again. From TJ Leaf to Alonzo Ball. Look at Leaf come down with the defensive rebound. He busts out. He throws it just behind the three-point arc. Ball catches it with two and puts it down strong.
Great camera angle too, Johnny. I like how you're creative with that, mate. See that?
Beautiful. 64-56 the lead now for the Bullets. Got about 5:50 to go in the third quarter. Holiday running the show here for the Bruins. Gets it over to Leaf. Leaf picks up his dribble, looking for Hamilton. Good defense here by Kenyon. Hamilton looking to go one-on-one. Kicks it out. Welsh, top of the key, jumper is short. Rebound Tarangi.
Again, Kenyon looking good defensively, keeping his guy out of the middle.
Now Jervis has it. Good look inside for Bruce. It's not there, so the point guard will bring it back out. But they're going to get Tommy Jervis for the moving pick. Bruins down 8, 64-56. I like Coach Alford leaving the young fella in here. He knows Ball needs to get the confidence up. Let's see if he runs something here. Here's that high screen and roll. Leaf picks it up, flips up the hook shot. It's no good. Jervis comes down with it. Now Kenyon flips it back to the big man, probably a bit early. Good defense there by Hamilton. They're going to call a defensive foul. I thought that might have been offensive with the elbow.
Well, I thought it might have been a walk. So good outcome for the Bullets.
Good outcome for the Bullets. Not what you want from the UCLA Bruins. That's the third personal foul there on Isaac Hamilton.
And again, we talk about learning and developing, and I think, I don't know, if Matt Kenyon really wants to hit the big guy as he's coming down the floor, what do you think, Thunder? That's your thing, fill in the middle.
You're a resident big guy.
Well, I think Jervis showed great touch and great skill to catch it and make a play out of it, because you're right. I reckon you got to wait one or two more steps and let him get position. Give it to him early so he can catch it in stride. But when there's traffic like that, let him take one more step, seal up, and then dump it down there for an easy hook shot. Jervis made a pretty difficult pass look pretty good, and credit to him for doing it.
Ball gets his feet in the paint, kicks it out for Hamilton. Hamilton looking inside and out of Walsh. Ball's open, gets it on the deck, looks inside for Leaf. Leaf is fouled from behind by Bruce. Great look there by Lonzo Ball.
Well, I like Hamilton. He's doing a little coaching on the floor, and he's like, hey, Welsh, you should have been stepping in, and I got you for 2 points just then. But because he hung out in the short corner, he missed him.
Yeah, Isaac Hamilton, one of the senior leaders of this UCLA Bruins squad. And Thomas Welsh, also an upperclassman. He's a junior out of Redondo Beach, California.
And Lonzo Ball can shoot the long-range basket. Like, we've seen that on tape. We've seen in glimpses of it tonight. But doesn't he look good when he doesn't settle for that? When he gets feet in the paint there, he's either going to shoot it. If there's no help, the help comes, and he's dumping off to the big guys for layups or fouls like we just saw then. He's just such a great creator, and I think he needs to force it a little bit further.
I like Leaf's game, too. He looks really nice for a young fella, too. 66-57 the lead. 4:45 to go in the third quarter. Kenyon gets the screen from Jervis. Hits Bruce. Bruce now working off of a Walker screen. Going back door, Lucas Walker finishes through Walsh. It's 68-57 now for the Bullets. Holiday working against Bruce, looking to go baseline. Bruce picks up another offensive foul on Holiday. Can't tell if that was playful or not.
Well, he's not happy, but again, you can't get him any square on the chest. That's the right call. What one thing I think he's an area that he needs to work on a little bit too is the use of the screen. What do you know, Dan? I mean, giving him too much space, you got to come off and you got a shoulder rub to the guy's hip and really rub off your guard.
And it's stuff that he would have gone back in elementary school and been told, but sometimes when you're as talented as these guys are, when you're in high school and even in the college game, you can get away with that. But against quality, older, experienced professionals like they're playing tonight, you can't make those errors in your right. It's too easy to defend.
Here comes Ball in transition, gets to the rack, flips it up. It's no good. Welsh comes down with the rebound. He falls and loses the ball out of bounds. Bit frustrated there. Ryan Vines checking in for Sean Bruce. Vines, known as the captain. Another Southwest Metro Pirates on the court with his teammate Jared Bairstow. Bullets have Walker, Vines, Jarvis, Bairstow, and Kenyon. UCLA answers with Holiday, Welsh, Ball, Hamilton, and Goleman. Jervis hands it off for Bairstow. Good screen and roll here. Good action for Jervis. He bit too strong. On the layup attempt.
Yeah, good execution from the Bullets as they went through a couple sets and had a great look at the bucket. You're pretty happy with that look.
Hamilton against Kenyon. A lot of contact there. Hamilton flips it up and in. Good finish there by Isaac Hamilton. Just bullied his way through Matt Kenyon.
And again, you know, good pedigree. His brother plays in the NBA. And I'm sure he's working on the same dream.
Ball comes up with another steal. That's his fourth of the night. Holiday has it, spins, flips one up. Can't get it to finish. It's tipped by Goleman. Holiday winds up with it, throws up a shot. He's fouled, and he's going to go to line for two shots. Isaac Hamilton was looking for the ball on the left wing there. He wanted the three-point shot. It looks like there's a timeout taken on the floor, so we'll take one as well. We're under 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. It's a 68-59 lead for the Brisbane Bullets over the UCLA Bruins here from Logan Metro Sports Center. back here at Logan Metro Sports Center, where the Brisbane Bullets lead the UCLA Bruins 68-59. While I have a second, I want to give a shout out to former Brisbane Bullets championship manager Big Joe and the championship winning head coach Joey Wright. Guys tuning in down in Adelaide, doing a bit of early season scouting. I wonder what they think of the Bullets' performance.
No comment, right? It's on.
It's on.
Brisbane's back.
Brisbane's back, baby.
We had a part-time love with Adelaide, but now it's over. I'm sorry.
We always got love for you guys down there in Adelaide. 68-59 the lead here for the Bulls.
But I still love Joey and Big Joe.
Holiday at the free throw line for two shots. He hits the first one. And I like what Holiday's doing. He's the one who kind of brought the Bruins back into it at the second quarter there. He's trying to take over now to get this team back within a few points.
Yeah, I think, as you know, like we talked about, ball settling for some sort of average shots, and I think he can get a lot better, and so can UCLA if they get through their sets. In particular, if it breaks down, you know you've got Holiday on an on-ball, and he's tough as.
Jarvis has it with 5 seconds to go on the shot clock, finds a cutting Barris, though. His jumper is no good. Vines with the offensive rebound. Jarvis comes up with it. Now Petrie has it. He's going to reset. Puts the ball on the deck. Flips one up. It's no good. Welsh with a strong rebound. Rips it out of the hands of Jared Barris, though. Now Holiday has it. Goes behind his back. Spins. Kicks it out for Lonzo Ball. Ball getting his feet in the paint. Kicks it. A good ball movement here. Leads to a wide open Hamilton three. That's way short. Great ball movement, though, from the Bruins.
Yeah, and you can see Ball with that one-hand pass, which is gets him, you know, obviously he does some great things, but also can get him in trouble, being a little bit turnover prone. But, you know, that just, again, you see the class in the guy. One dribble, throwing it, one-handed bounce passes, hitting guys right in the box.
Petrie going against Golliman. Good contest there. Welsh picks up the defensive rebound. He'll hand off for Lonzo Ball.
And this could realistically be the first time in Lonzo Ball's life that he hasn't been the most physically talented player on the court. I mean, he's obviously oozing class and talent, but it's the first time he's playing against men, and it's an adjustment that he's going to learn to make, and especially if he does play 1 or 2 years of college ball, he'll be playing against men again pretty soon. So experiences like this tonight, while he doesn't look as impressive as he would have wanted to, it's just going to help him so much in the long term.
Great play there by Jarvis, spinning through the contact from Lonzo Ball and finishing. Again, ball gets caught on the big guy. The Bullets doing a great job recognizing it and taking advantage of the mismatch.
Yeah, and you can see they've intentionally tried that all night long to try and get that mismatch.
And why is UCLA continuing to switch it? When the first half it's hurt, it continues to hurt them here. If Tom Jervis is doing a dribble handoff, why are we going to switch that? We don't want our point guard all of a sudden matched up on a 7-footer getting back down in the post.
All right, guys, timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. 1:22 to go in the third quarter. It's a 70-63 lead for the Brisbane Bullets over the UCLA Bruins here from Logan Metro Sports Center. Welcome back to Logan Metro Sports Center as the Brisbane Bullets host the UCLA Bruins from the NCAA Division I ranks. At the moment, it's a 7-point lead for the Bullets over UCLA, 70-63. Good time out there from Coach Alford. I think he's just trying to get the troops. Guys, let's start to run our offense a bit.
Yeah, and it's a really good learning environment. And maybe I disagree, Johnny. Maybe he was talking defensively on how we're going to try and defend that a little bit better.
So far
they've struggled with that, and they're not making the adjustments and taking a great deal away from the Bullets.
Holiday has it. He's going to fire a three over Jervis, and he rattles that one home. Holiday is starting to heat up again, the lead 5 for Brisbane.
Well, I think Holiday put up 10 points and 4 assists a game as a freshman last season, and he's showing all the signs on both ends of the floor that he's going to be a super quality player this year for the Bruins.
Yeah, he's only a sophomore as well. He got the start in the first couple games, I think. Came off the bench tonight, but he's doing a great job. He leads the Bruins in scoring with 13 points. Only other player with double figures for UCLA is Ike Anabogu. with 11, and sorry, Alford has 11 too.
Well, Hamilton's had a bit of a quiet night so far. He's been good for them on this tour, and we'll see if he's the new focal point.
That foul is going to go on Aaron Holiday. Petrie had Hamilton in the block. Holiday reaching in when he tries to cheat down low.
And there was a lot of ball on that reach in too. Holiday, he's had a couple of calls where it's looked questionable. That one, he really wasn't happy. So Petrie might have got a little bit lucky with two foul shots in that possession.
I think it's always one of the biggest challenges for these teams when they come over from the States is to get adjusted to the referees and understand they're not going to get the same calls that they got at home down under.
Yeah, and again, it's quite a different style of play. So a little bit more physicality. And again, depending on the team, sometimes they switch, sometimes they won't switch.
Holiday now on kicker, over to Hamilton. Hamilton puts it on the deck, flips one up. What a pretty layup there from Isaac Hamilton. Gets it to roll with the right hand. Now Petrie has it on the wing. I think this is one of the strengths of an Andre Lamanis team as Bruce gets open and lays it in. But just the action off the ball is phenomenal to watch. The backdoor cuts, it's constant motion, constant screening and rolling. It's just a really beautiful game of basketball to watch.
In particular, Bruce has looked really good off the ball. Again, moving and keeping his man honest.
As Isaac Hamilton beats the buzzer, I think UCLA has beaten the buzzer in all three quarters. Hamilton hits the jumper to send it into the quarter time break. 75-70 the lead for the Brisbane Bullets. Guys, quick thoughts on the third quarter action.
Well, it's an impressive quarter from both groups, and I think both teams made runs and both teams could have pushed the lead out. So the fact that we've got a 5-point game here heading into the fourth quarter is really positive signs for everybody involved that we're going to have a really great finish tonight.
Dave?
Yeah, I think, again, Coach Alford's gone to his bench a little bit more in that third quarter. And again, just looking to run his stuff, get through some substitutions. And I'm looking forward to a really nice, tight fourth quarter. As you know, when it gets down to it, both coaches want to win. They don't care about exhibition. That means nothing.
Of course, both teams want the win. It's 75-70 in the favor of the Brisbane Bullets here. We'll take a break. We'll come back with the fourth quarter action live from Logan Metro Sports Center. Back here at the Logan Metro Sports Center, it's a 75-70 lead for the Brisbane Bullets over the UCLA Bruins. Let's take a quick look at some stats here as Bullets get a good, really balanced contribution from their whole roster. Everyone who's seen the court has pretty much got on the stat sheet.
Yeah, and they're really sharing the ball and doing a good job, shooting 43% from the field, 30% from the three. They're plus two on the rebounding. And again, it's been a pretty quality game. A couple of loose passes, but only 12 turnovers for the Bullets, 14 for the Bruins. So both teams are looking after the ball.
No doubt, but we see Brisbane through three quarters is one of five from downtown. And that'll change with Beals and Gibbos coming into the lineup during the regular season as Kickett looks for a mismatch down good low.
That's a good defense there. Tony Caldwell telling Coach Alford, wait, that's why I blew my whistle. It was the travel.
Well, Coach Alford doesn't know that Tony's an international-level ref, but fair enough for him. Like Dave said, Coach Alford wants to win this ball game, so he's going to ride these refs too. But, I mean, to the point about 5 3-point attempts for one make for Brisbane, that's to me just shows that UCLA got to stop switching and take away the post game. And if Brisbane start knocking down threes and beat you from there, then you live with that.
Yeah, Hamilton's heating up, though.
Three-pointer there from Isaac Hamilton. It's a 75-73 lead now, so great job defensively on the block. He got the turnover, and then he hits the three on the other end. Great look inside. Tarangi can't finish, but he's fouled there by Thomas Welsh.
Well, Welsh didn't do a whole lot wrong.
Must have been with the body. Tony Caldwell going to give him the call. So Tarangi is going to go to the line for a couple free throw opportunities here.
Look for Brisbane to come out in some type of press here. We hear Coach Bruden barking instructions. Wouldn't surprise me if they put on a little bit of three-quarter court defensive pressure here out of this dead ball.
Tarangi misses the first one. Haven't seen Coach Lamanis is just in the corner there, keeping an eye on things. He must be pretty happy with what he's seen. Actually coming back from Rio de Janeiro, where he had a successful Olympics campaign. Probably not the success he wanted, but I got to tell you, he must be happy with the team. They look like they're in mid-season form, to be honest with you, considering the guys who are playing.
Well, Coach Lamanis and his Boomers team made Australia love basketball again. So we didn't medal, but it was a success, no doubt about it. And if I'm him over there at the moment, I'm looking at this game. I'm watching us run our structures so efficiently. It just gives me so much confidence in the CJ and Ace and these guys that have been training them to know that while he's been away, they've been putting in quality work.
Good look inside Petrie to Jervis. He misses the hook shot.
And they got potentially three starters to come back in as well. Four starters to come back in.
Alford firing the three. He thought there was contact. Referees didn't blow the whistle.
Yeah, that looked like a foul. I think she probably didn't just missed it as he came over the screen.
Bruce kicks it to Kickert. Three-pointer is up. It's good for Daniel Kickert. It's 79-73 the lead now for the Bullets.
Well, he's 2 of 3 from downtown. Made the only 2 threes for the Bullets.
Well, Kickert was a couple of percentage points away from joining the 50-40-90 club last season. 50% field goal shooting. 40% from the three and 90 from the free throw lines. He's a quality shooter as UCLA answer as well.
Yeah, Olashinsky with the three-pointer there for the Bruins. It's a three-point lead here. Coach Alford looking for some foul calls inside. He's working the referees like it's mid-season here. It was a foul call, though. It was against UCLA. That's their second team foul.
Great-looking Jimmy from Olashinsky before on the three. He's listed at 6'10", but he looks pretty long as well, so... You know, he's five man.
Yeah, he's a 6'10 sophomore out of Roswell, New Mexico. He had some pretty solid minutes for them last year as a freshman. Probably see a few more minutes this season. 79-76 the lead here for the Bullets. Tarangi going to take Holiday into the paint. He flips one up. No call there. Olashinsky can't save it. Holiday tries to, but it goes out of bounds.
I love the D from Holiday. Nice, tough. Tarangi really tried to give it to him, and Holiday didn't take a step backward foot.
Yeah, if I'm Coach Alford, I love that. We've seen Hamilton with a bigger guy taking him into the post, holding his ground, defending well. Holiday doing a great job there. You know, Holiday's listed at 6'1". Tarangi's about 6'6".
And I love the no call from the officials, too. Yeah. Real easy to bail him out there, but it's just two big boys going to work. Let them play.
Ball now has it over to Olashinsky. He hands off for Alford. Alford stepping back, going to fire the three. That's good.
That is
he
a
looked
smooth.
Like he was off balance there, and now we're knotted at 79.
That went from a bad shot to a great shot.
Yep.
Real quick.
That happens when you drain it. We're all tied at 79. Coach Alford really working the troops here. Tarangi trying to get into the paint. Kicks it out for Walker. He'll fire a top of the key three. That's off. That's on a Bogu. Come down with it.
Yeah, good adjustment again from Holiday. As, again, Tarangi's really not going to shoot the three unless he's really open. He's pump faked it a couple times, put it on the floor. Holiday's like, I've got you worked out now.
Six seconds to go on the shot clock. Holiday has it. He spins into the paint. He's going to stop and pop. It's up. It's off, though. Fighting for the rebound on a Bogu. They're calling a foul here on one of the Bullets. Let's see who they give it to. That one's going to go on Ruben Tarangi. That's Tarangi's fourth personal. It's the second team foul for the Bullets in the quarter.
And geez, Holiday looks good these last few minutes. But to your point, Dave, we have said that other than Kickett, no one from Brisbane has looked like a threat from the three-point line at all. And Holiday has made that adjustment. And he's cutting off penetration. And Brisbane doesn't look as good when he's been doing that. So credit a young player for making a really smart read and adjusting.
Let's see what UCLA can do here. Alford going to step into another three. That's short. Bruce off and running. He's trying to get right to the rack. Flips it up. What a swat there by Holiday. That's number two. He's helping the cameraman along the baseline. Got that one because that was nasty. Ball now on the other end, firing a three. Gets that one to finally rattle home. And here comes UCLA. They've taken the lead, 82-79.
Yeah, the boys are getting really pumped up here now. Defensively getting in, offensively. Being better physicality on both ends from the Bruins as well.
Let's see if the Bullets can respond. Kicker it over to Tarangi. Kicks it into Kenyon in the corner. His three is good. Matty Kenyon with the big answer. We're not at 82.
Great extra pass from Tarangi as well.
Good ball movement there by the Bullets. Alford has it. Looking for the screen. It's not there. He wants Ball to come and get it. Steady, he'll hand off for Holiday. 5 seconds now on the shot clock. Let's see what Holiday can do with it. He's in a bit of trouble, loses his feet, flips one up. I thought it was going in. It was off on the side. Just a bit rusty there. Coach Alford not happy with that one. And now Tarangi gets his feet in the paint, flips it up. What a swap by Anabogu. We've seen a few huge blocks. Holiday loses it. They're going to say he was fouled by Bruce. Let's take a look at this block there by Ike Anabogu. Tarangi. Very aggressive in the paint. He comes in off the screen, tries to get to the rack, and Anabogu swats it off the backboard. What a swat there.
I'm buying stocks in Anabogu. He's just a super impressive player. Coming in as a, he's going to have a big season for this Bruins team. If he's doing that tonight against men, wait till he goes into the Pac-12. He's going to have a great year.
I love that one. There's a timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. 5:13 to go in the game. It's 82 all here from Logan Metro Sports Center. Leaf back on the court. We haven't seen him for a while. He goes pick and roll with Ball. Good contest. Whoa. Anabogu, though, with a follow-up dunk. This guy's an animal. What a follow dunk. You left him weak side, and he makes you pay. Bruce over now to Tarangi. Goes off a Jervis screen. Good hesitation. Kicks it over to Walker. Anabogo doing a great job on defense as well. Walker flips it up. It's no good. Jervis tips it around. Oh! Another huge swat by Anabogo. He lets Jervis know about that one as well.
But we saw Brisbane run an on ball, and UCLA do not switch. They stay at home, which leaves Anabogo there to protect the rim. And obviously, he's pretty good at doing that.
I mean, I just got to cut highlights here of Ike Anabogo because he is putting on a clinic on both ends of the court. Bit of jawing going back and forth as Anabogo was holding his ground. No physical play there. Tarangi didn't like that out of him. Coach Alfred's going to give the young fella a breather. He doesn't want him to do anything silly, I guess,
he deserved it.
The crowd deserves it as well. He's putting on the show.
And his stock's skyrocketing
now. I'm glad I bought it a minute ago because it just went up. But he'll be sitting down for a minute at most.
Yeah.
I think that's a sub, like you said, to make sure that, hey, big fella, keep you cool.
Yeah.
Have a drink, get back in there and protect the rim for us.
Yeah, and again, you know, this means something for the Bullets too. They haven't been here for 10 years. You know, this is the first time they've been back as a franchise, and, you know, they want to play.
Bruce can't get the jumper to fall. Leaf knocked it out. They thought it was in the cylinder. Everyone but the referees thought it was. Now UCLA has an opportunity to increase the lead. 86-84 the lead. Ball has it. They're going to switch again. Good recognition by Ball. What a pass to Welsh, who hits the jump shot.
When Ball gets his feet in the paint, UCLA look awesome.
Yeah, and if I'm a big, I better move my feet and get my hands up, and I'm going to get rewarded.
Now Kickert has it. He'll hand off for Kenyon. Kenyon dribbling against Hamilton. He'll flip one up. It's no good, but there's a foul. Let's see who they give this one to. Wants to have a chat with Bryce Alford, one of the referees here. Nope. Thought he was calling Bryce Alford over. That foul is going to go on number 10. That's Isaac Hamilton. That's going to be Hamilton's fifth personal foul. So he's done for the night.
And that's a big loss for UCLA with plenty of time left in the game. I thought Hamilton's been playing great, both ends of the floor.
Yeah, absolutely. He had a great run in the third quarter there. And again, he hasn't played a great deal tonight either, Dan. I mean, but he's been good for them the last couple games.
He's been their top scorer on the tour so far. He came in tonight averaging 18 a game. He'll finish tonight with 16.
Well, and going into his senior year, it's the kind of leadership that he wants to show. I mean, he led the team in scoring for all of last season at 17 a game. So he's proven to be a scorer at a high level. And he must be excited to now be playing with some really talented freshmen in what's going to be hopefully a really good season for the Bruins.
Yeah, Kenyon hits both free throws, two big ones for the youngster. UCLA going to try and work a bit of clock here. They're going to go with that Welsh ball screen. Good in and out dribble. Alley-oop pass for Leaf. He finishes strong with two. What vision there by Lonzo Ball. And how about the big fella getting up in the sky and bringing it home?
And again, it's off ball penetration. We don't want to say too much about it, but he settled for that jump shot a lot tonight, which will be there, but when he's penetrating, attacking, geez, you must love playing with him because he's diming everyone up.
Yeah, and again, that comes when there's good ball movement because the Bruins handled the Bullets' pressure.
Bryce gets on the court. There's a scrap for it with Tarangi and Alford. It's a jump ball. Possession arrow is going to favor UCLA. Coach Alford loves the hustle. Let's take a look at that alley-oop, though, fellas. Lonzo Ball gets his feet in the paint. Ball coming off the screen here from Walsh. You see the replay. He throw it up for Leaf, who catches it and finishes strong.
And
there's
my bad. My bad for standing up in right in front of the camera, too. But I was excited.
All right, guys. Timeout on the floor. We'll take one as well. 2:33 to go in the game. It's a four-point lead now for the Bruins. 90-86 over the Brisbane Bullets here at Logan Metro Sports Center. Welcome back to Logan Metro Sports Center as the UCLA Bruins now lead the Brisbane Bullets 90-86 with 2:30 to go. Guys, the Bruins have done a great job to get themselves back into it. Lonzo Ball, Holiday, and Leaf leading the charge here.
Well, we spoke pregame about the excitement of the Bullets' return, and I'm still really excited about what their season's going to look like with the guys they've coming back.
Ball fires the three. It's tipped out. It winds up with Holiday. Now Alford has it. He wanted to shoot, but he knows his team's in the lead. Ball dumps it off for Welsh. Back to Lonzo Ball. Thinks about the three. Quick first step. Tries to go behind his back. It's stolen by Matty Kenyon. Now Bruce has it. He's got a three on two. He'll stop. Look inside for Tarangi. That's great recognition there from Sean Bruce.
Yeah, good decision in trans from Bruce.
And we also spoke pregame about UCLA's tradition and their history. So I'm excited for their season too. This has just been a quality product on the floor tonight from both teams.
Welsh has it now, top of the key. He'll hand off for Alford. Alford working on Bruce. Good defense there from Sean Bruce. Holiday now back to Alford. Alford tries to use the pump fake. He'll step into a long two. That's off. Welsh tips it around. Matty Kenyon with another nice board.
Yeah, Welsh, good job on the board, but no one else for the Bruins. All four of them looked like they're falling in love with the jump shot a little bit.
And then Bruce throws up a floater. That rattles out. Welsh comes down with it for UCLA. They're up two.
Well, I think Anaboga has got to come back in quickly because he gives him that opportunity for a second chance bucket.
Here's the chance of defense. Ball and Leaf doing the two-man game. Now Holiday back to Ball at halfway. Looking to do a little screen and roll here. Ball nearly loses it. He does lose it out of bounds just to the left of us here. Not happy with the handle. And Coach Steve Alford's going to take a timeout. He's going to have a chat with his young horse.
Yeah, I think he's just trying to do a little bit too much the last sort of little bit. Again, just break it down, really simplify the offense, move it around, fatigue the Bullets D, and then you can look at getting him and Holiday off the seams. Because when they penetrate, it's lights out.
Well, I think UCLA, when they were making their run, did a great job of moving the ball. So if they want to make a play like that, do it off two or three ball reversals. I think he almost felt the need to create something himself, but that's a good example, I think, of trusting the system, run your sets. When you get off the second or third reversal, then attack it like that, because
yep,
you'll have so much more space to operate in.
Well, I think we also see on that particular possession, the Bruins kind of defaulting to Lonzo Ball as well, looking for him to create something. He didn't use the screen. Welsh kind of said a half a screen there, so Ball went away from it. Guys, what do the Bullets need to do, though? It's a minute to go. They're down two. I'd like to see what Coach Bruton draws up on this timeout. Or a couple of plays, the Bruins have done a better job defensively shutting down that backdoor cut
no
and
doubt.
That motion offense.
Well, I want to get a quick bucket. I'm probably running a set play to get a look in the post quickly here. Come back and get a stop, and you still give yourself two possessions then to end the game.
Well, I'm the same, Thunder. I'm looking for a Jarvis special like they ran before, and the Bruins struggled to defend it. So let's go back to some bread and butter and see how they defend it this time.
UCLA has Ball, Alford, Leaf, Welsh, and Holiday. Bullets answer with Tarangi, kicker, Jarvis, Kenyon, and Sean Bruce. Jarvis gets it at the elbow, extended. Now top of the key for Kickert. Things are quiet here. Where's the Bullets crowd? As Kenyon drives the paint, he's blocked from behind by Lonzo Ball, and TJ Leaf comes down with it for UCLA. That's about their seventh block shot of the night. Holiday.
It's been a theme of their tour as well, using that athleticism and length they have. And great job being active from Ball, not giving up on the play as they turn it over.
Yeah, a bit of miscommunication. Kenyon tips it. They're not going to say over and back. There's 4 seconds on the shot clock. Leaf's got to get the shot up. He flips it up. It's off. Ball, though, with the offensive rebound. Bullets have to foul here. There's only about a 9-second differential. And there's the foul from Ruben Tarangi. He's the one you didn't want to foul because that's his fifth personal. But it's only the third team foul for the Bullets with 18.4 seconds to go in the game.
Well, great hustle from Kenyon. But by getting a hand on the ball, it wasn't a backcourt violation. He touched it first. So that gives UCLA a chance to come down and have an extra possession, which they probably shouldn't have had.
And I love the fact that Ball went to the offensive glass, gets a big one when the game counts. That's what the true great players can do.
If it's not your night, you got to do all those little things to get yourself going. He's had a better second half than the first half and a great O board there.
And I think Bryce Alford's going to make sure he gets a look here, because if Brisbane don't want to pass someone, it's Bryce Alford.
Yeah.
Yep. Alford, he's a He hasn't missed the free throw on the tour yet. And there's the foul. It's only the fourth team foul, though, for the Bullets.
Well, they're going to run that same play again. And you can see Bryce Alpha doesn't even think about passing. He's just going to catch it and hold it, wait for the foul, because he knows that chances are it's like shooting a layup for him from the foul line.
One more for Brisbane, and they'll be in the penalty. Better job here from the Bullets. Welsh gets it. That's a nice secondary action there for UCLA to get all for the ball.
Yeah, great release pass from release from Welsh. And again, good execution from the Bruins when it counts.
And now Alford will go to the line for two shots. Looking for a towel. He's got some sweaty hands, sweaty palms. Oh, Tony Caldwell giving up the leg there.
Do we have that on replay?
Now Bryce Alford is going to go to the line for a couple shots here. Two free throws could potentially wrap this up here, guys, with 14 seconds to go.
Yeah, great demonstration of hoops back in Brisbane. Both teams have been really good tonight, and I think the fans will be really super happy and pumped up for a Bullets season in 2016-17.
Well, there's so much to be excited about.
Yeah.
The guys that have played tonight, if that was all that they had, I'd be excited to watch them play every week.
Yeah.
But when you look at imports to come in, Adam Gibson, Olympian, Cam Bairstow, an NBA player, looking at these guys they're going to add, man, it's going to be a pretty good year of basketball in Brisbane.
Alford hits the first. Second one is up. That's good as well. So it's now 4 points the lead. And Coach Steve Alford going to his bench. He's going to insert G.G. Golliman.
I'm surprised that Anaboga's not in here just to protect the rim for this last possession for Brisbane.
Vines has it. They got to get a shot off here quick. It's Kickert for three. It's up. It's good from Daniel Kickert. The lead's cut to one. They're going to have to foul right away. Good job denying Alford. It's going to be Holiday who's going to go to the line for two shots. But a great set run there for the Bullets to get that three-pointer.
Yeah, really good execution again. Kickett City's third three of the night.
And Holiday's going to go to the line for a couple of free throws.
I just thought Coach Bruton was asking for his own sub.
He wants in.
He wants to check in. He's like, throw me a jersey.
Well, Sam, this is his time.
Five seconds to go. That's what I do.
Holiday hits the first. Let's see if he can hit the second. The crowd making lots of noise. He hits them both. It's a three-point lead. The Bullets need a three-pointer to send it to overtime. Vines has it. He flips it up, and they're going to call a foul as Ryan Vines. And Coach Alford is losing his marbles. He can't believe the foul call. Well, so Ryan Vines is going to go to the line for three shots and an opportunity to tie the game.
And let's go, Ryan. Young Brisbane kid. Knock these down, big fella. But Coach Alford, I don't know what he's upset about. They wanted to draw the foul, but they waited so long to do it that he let Ryan Vines get a shot off. They should have fouled him in the backcourt right here to make them take it out again. That was a mistake from UCLA. I don't know what the coach is upset about here.
I think that's what he was looking for. He wants the foul called earlier, I think. But he's going to take a timeout to reset.
I think that was the right call. It was
100% the right call.
Poorly done from the Bruins. And,
no doubt about it.
We don't have it on replay, unfortunately, so let's say it was the right call. But
doesn't matter. At the end of the day, the referees blew the call. Now Vines is going to go to the line for three shots with an opportunity to tie the game.
Well,
this is prime time opportunity here for the captain, Ryan Vines.
Let's hope Vines hits three. We go to OT. Let's get our money's worth.
There you go.
Yeah,
I think Ryan Vines for feeling the foul and being smart enough to launch it as well. That's a great heads-up play from him. And like we said, he's had an unbelievably good season in our local Queensland league. So let's hope that all the hard work he puts in on a big stage like tonight, he rewards himself by knocking these down.
Well, they're going to have to box out too. You know, he might make two, intentionally miss possibly. Oh, no, he can't. No, he's got to make them all.
But if they get the tip, big fella.
They get the tip.
Give me three. But I like your strategy.
Let's go for the win.
And Anabogu, I'm not sure if he's out of the game in foul trouble. But
here he is.
I was going to say, I'm glad he's back in if I'm UCLA, because if there is a miss, he'll probably grab it from what we've seen so far tonight.
He's a glass cleaner, that's for sure. And the captain, Ryan Vines, at the line for three shots with this team down three. First one, though, is off by Ryan Vines. He's got to hit these two. He must hit these two, and then they got to hope for a quick foul.
Well, he's got to hit this one and then miss the second.
It's
going
to be tough to get a long rebound with a second and a half.
And Anabogu on the block.
Oh.
This is the second as well. UCLA pretty happy. They think they're going to be finishing off their road trip with a win. He misses. It's up. Anabogu comes down with it. And the UCLA Bruins are going to finish up their exhibition tour of Australia with a 94-91 win over the Brisbane Bullets. It was a fantastic game, and what a comeback from the UCLA Bruins to pull out the victory in the fourth quarter.
Absolutely. I mean, there were runs made by both teams. And like we said during the call, both teams should be pretty excited about their respective seasons ahead. But I was really impressed when Brisbane took it up a level and started playing some really physical D and really pounded the ball inside on O. UCLA and their younger players stood up to the challenge. They answered with their own level of physicality, and they've come out with a really hard-fought win on the road after a long trip that they've had. I mean, I'm really impressed with some of their guys, and if I was a UCLA fan watching this, I'd be looking forward to their season.
Dave?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I think they really turned it up in that second half, and you know, they wanted to go home and have a good hit out, and they certainly wanted to win. Unlike a lot of times they just get guys through, they really wanted to win, up the ante physically, and executed well down the stretch.
Great game. What do you think of the Bullets, though, guys? I thought it was a really impressive performance from Brisbane as well. I think UCLA amped up the defensive pressure in the second half. Brisbane withstood that rush, and unfortunately they couldn't get the win. But what a return to Brisbane for the Bullets, guys. You're impressed with the Bullets' performance tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, some of the young guys were great. I thought Kenyon gave good minutes. Besto was good. Petrie was good. Kickett was knocking down his shots. You know, really good hit out for them. And again, they've only been playing for about a month or so in preseason. So this is really early days for them.
Well, we have such a quality league in Australia. Sometimes it's easy to forget how good the Wollongongs are with Bevo and the Adelaides, like we shouted out, in Sydney. And I mean, every team is quality. So Brisbane's going to have their work cut out. Every single week is going to be a battle for them to get a W. But from what we've seen tonight, there is plenty for the Brisbane community to be excited about. And I think from what we've seen with the full house here, the ticket sales for Brisbane so far have been great. I think we're going to see a team that's really well supported by the community, and I hope that the Bullets players give back to that community that's going to support them. So it's going to be a good season for UCLA. We know that. It's going to be a good season for Brisbane, especially when their full squad gets here.
Yeah, we have head coach tonight, CJ Bruton from the Brisbane Bullets. Coach, that was a great game. What are your thoughts on the performance of you guys?
It was a half butt effort. I think defensively we know we're not where we need to be, and offensively while Dre's been gone, we've been working through a lot of things, and you deal with injuries, but that's just making an excuse for the guys that are here and able to play. We've had a little bit of time together, maybe not a lot, especially on the floor, not enough when you allow 2 hours of practice and you only practice for an hour, because that's as much load as you can handle within the group. But I'm happy with offensively, as I told them, they need to move the ball a little more. We sat on it a little bit, and we did some things, which was there was some pretty stuff, and there was some stuff there that looking after the basketball, as you know, through junior ranks all the way to QBL and see, well, you just got to, those things of, you can't pass. They're athletes. As you saw, that they climbed up on the backboard and they smacked everything like we were playing volleyball around here. So to know that in transition that, you know, you turned the ball over a few times, that there's a few points that you just gave to the other team. And defensively, you know, giving up a few shots and a few missed assignments overall. There's a lot to work on, but I'm happy with the five or the six guys that we had from our squad that were able to contribute. It's something that we can go look at the video and go for it.
Yeah, how about this crowd? I think the community definitely is certainly ready for the Bullets to return. It was a great crowd tonight.
Yeah, this is it was amazing to know that it was sold out, you know, 2 weeks in advance, and getting phone calls all the way to that, even on the drive here, about getting tickets to the first Bullets game. I'm like, I'm a coach. I get two tickets, and I get tickets for my family. So, and I have to pay for them. So just for everyone to know out there that's listening, please don't call me for tickets.
So, Jay, we thought UCLA made some good adjustments defensively to close the game out. But for 3.5 quarters, we thought you guys ran your structures pretty well, got looks for the right guys.
Yeah.
I know that there's a lot of guys missing to come into the team tonight, but how pleased are you, given you've had Dre away and you've had some key guys not able to train? How happy were you with the way that you executed offensively?
Offensively, it was. I was very happy with their timing, their poise, the looks that they had, and the opportunity. Some they didn't take the opportunity. Like Kick had quite a few open threes he just didn't take. He'll show you that I had that shot if I really wanted to take it, but you know, I'll just run the play. So overall, being able to go inside, I think Jervis, I think I waited a little longer to get him involved, and when I did, I went to the well and to the point where he was too tired, I had to take him out of the ball game.
Well,
so
we saw Petrie look pretty effective almost from the three spot, which, like, preseason, I'm saying he's probably almost a small ball five at times. So for him to run the three, looking pretty good in that spot as well.
Yeah, well, speaking to Dre just before the game, he says, man, you didn't realize that we have the biggest team in the league. We have a lot of different mismatches and different options that we can go to with the rest of the guys coming in, and knowing that TC and Dollar, like, they've been on fire. They came in and they came in great shape. They bought into everything that the Bullets are all about. And it's going to be a great fun season. I'm looking forward to it.
I like, what did you think about in particular the D of Bruce and Kenyon? I thought they were terrific. I mean, UCLA had some great athletes, and they did a great job of staying in front and containing their man. I mean, that's a real positive sign.
Definitely.
When you can sort of bring them in.
Oh, yeah. I think anytime you know that you have that sort of talent on your bench that can get up the floor and crawl in, that have a basketball IQ and patience and the poise to be able to take the options that are there and know how to run a play down to a T. It's definitely handy, and Kenyon being a puppy and having the jets that he has that can get up and down the floor. He's had a couple ankle injuries in the last couple of weeks, but his bounce is crazy. I know that UCLA deserve a lot of credit for the way they've come in and played quite a few games and being able to adjust on the fly to Sydney Uni, to Melbourne United, and coming in from Kansas. You know, they're holidaying and traveling and training as well, so take nothing away from the win for them. This was, for us, it was great to get out here. I know everyone would love to see the Bullets win their very first game that they play. For me, it was, and as a coach, I really wanted to see them get out there and play, because the only opportunity that they have is this right now. And with a crowd in front of you, it's very important to build that as we keep going forward and playing a lot more games.
I think it was a great effort for the boys. I think there's a lot to work on, but there was a lot of positives as well. It does finish with a loss, but it's a win for the Brisbane community and the Bullets themselves.
Sure.
CJ, I know you got some media commitments, so I appreciate you taking the time to chat with us.
Appreciate
it. We're looking forward to the rest of the season.
Looking forward to it.
Guys, that's going to pretty much wrap things up for us here. Quick final thoughts from each of you on the performance from both teams. Quick.
I'll be quick. UCLA, good luck to you guys when you go home. I'm looking forward to you getting back up where you belong at the top of the conference in Brisbane. I'm so happy that the crowd and the city's behind you already, and we've got something to be pretty proud of from what we've seen tonight.
Dave?
Yeah, equally, thank you to UCLA for coming out here. We love trying to raise the game in Australia. So thank you for coming, and we'll see you hopefully in another 4 or 5 years when you're allowed to. And for the Bullets, you know, great first step forward. Again, Brisbane, get out, support the team, go buy your memberships, come out to the games, and let's try and get back to the titles, the aspirations that we rightfully deserve.
It's been a great product. Guys, that's going to wrap things up for us. I got to thank a few people. I got to thank Chris Sieber on the camera. I got to thank Regan Baker on the production panel. I got to thank Dan George and Dave Derwin for joining me in the commentary. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. Hope you enjoyed this broadcast. It's UCLA 94 over the returning Brisbane Bullets 91 here from Logan Sports Metro Complex.